You're watching Wayback Machine 1, Classic TV. Please subscribe today.
The TV shows and movies you grew up watching are here on Classic TV. Wayback Machine 1, the golden days of TV are back. Please subscribe today. Wayback Machine 1, Classic TV.
Classic TV, Wayback Machine 1.
From Nellis Air Force Base, Nevada, home of the Super Sabre Jet, it's the Milton Berle Show. Coming to you live tonight from the heart of the desert, with Milton's guests, Zsa Zsa Gabor, Denise, Darcel, Arnold, Stang, the four stepbrothers, the seven Ashtons, the Copa girls from the Sands Hotel, and Ray Anthony and his orchestra. Yes, Nellis Air Base, turning out thousands of jet fighter pilots to help defend the free countries of the world, is the largest combat training base in the United States. And here they come, America's first line of defense, zooming out of the wide blue yonder, joining forces tonight with the Milton Berle Show to bring you in full color and in black and white a program coming to you tonight direct from a jet Air Force base. Here at Nellis Air Force Base to be welcomed by thousands of airmen. Coming through the ozone at supersonic speed and about to break the laugh barrier. Coming down on the ground, Mr. Color Television himself, ladies and gentlemen, Milton Berle!
Do you ever fly in a Mixmaster? It is a great boy. What a mob here. Bet you the Red Rooster is empty. It is, I'm very, very... Will you keep this? Give it to the Colonel. I'm very, very happy, gentlemen, really, to be here at Nellis Air Base. Nellis is located in the Mojave Desert. It's in the Mojave Desert, and it was discovered by those two great pioneers, Moe and Harvey. I've never seen so many flyers in all my life. They were so thrilled, all these pilots, when I arrived. Really, they wanted to give me a party. I'm not kidding. The minute I got off the plane this afternoon, they said, there's the party. Let's give it over. This is really a great... I'm out of breath. What do you go through? This is really a great air base. I'm not kidding. It's only 8 miles from Las Vegas as the crow walks. He used to fly, but he got his wings clipped at the Desert Inn. That's a local place. In Nellis Field, there's no such thing as a buck private. After they get through in Vegas, they haven't got a buck left. Right? But there are thousands of jet pilots here, ladies and gentlemen. You know what a jet pilot is. That's a regular pilot with a snap in his flap. You know, a pilot, incidentally, is not considered a great pilot until he has spent 30 hours in the air and 20 minutes in searchlight. Now for the folks that are watching our show, Searchlight is a little town over here. It's a local chapter of the PTA. I mean, I love it here, but the weather sometimes is murderous. I never saw so many sandstorms in all my life, believe me. This is the only place where a soldier serves his country and eats it at the same time. I'm not kidding. You agree? Boy, I'm telling you, I never saw pilots eat in my life the way they eat here. Any kind of food. This morning, the mess sergeant yelled, "Come and get it." Between come and get, he got it. Really, these guys will eat anything you put on the table. In the mess hall, I'm laughing at this because I heard it. In the mess hall, they'll eat anything. I laid down my wristwatch before I knew it. The guy next to me was ticking. And they eat fast. Everything is speed here. In fact, the cook came up with a new sensational dish here. It's called instant heartburn. But they're really very, very friendly here at this base. If you want breakfast in bed, you just ring a bell and an arrow points to the nearest psychiatrist. And the captains, they're very friendly too. I found out what a captain is. That's a major who talked back to his colonel. This morning I met one of the colonels here and I noticed something peculiar about him. He had wearing both eagles on the same shoulder. Must have been mating season. But this, incidentally, get a load of the guy coming down. Get a load of the guy. Who are you looking for, Johnny? Out. I'm only kidding. I was in the Air Force myself. I wasn't exactly in the Air Force during the last war, but I blew up basketballs for the USO. Really, I remember when I went overseas with the USO, my wife was so concerned. I can still hear her parting words. She said, "Milton, darling, your insurance is paid up. Take chances." And my whole family were in the Air Force. My brother Frank, he was in the Air Force. For only 2 weeks, they made him a sergeant. Because before that, he was a lieutenant. I'm thinking, what a really had a wonder. He shot down two fighters, three bombers, and blew up four ammunition dumps. And then they sent him overseas. Oh, wait a minute. This I gotta tell you. This something funny happened here this morning. I'm not kidding. I was standing in the officers' club. And couldn't get a chair. They all had them. And I was standing in the officer's club, and I overheard some of the officers talking about love. Really, they were talking about love. And a colonel said, "Love is 50% pleasure and 50% work." Then I saw a major. He said, "No, love is 60% pleasure and 40% work." The captain said, "No, it's 80% pleasure and 20% work." Standing by was an enlisted man. He was mopping up the floor, so they asked him. He said, "It's 100% pleasure. Because if there was any work involved, you guys would have had me doing it years ago." Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. And now, for my encore, I'd like to introduce an act. And this is a very, very clever act. But first, before I introduce, I want you to tell you that tonight, we're bringing you fellas a jet-propelled show starring the very, very glamorous Zsa Zsa Gabor, the very, very exciting Denise Darcel, the very hilarious Arnold Stang. We have Ray Anthony and his entire orchestra, the four stepbrothers, and the seven sensational Ashtons. But first, I'd like to tell you who is bringing you the show tonight. Just, I want you to listen. Listen.
RCA! World leader in electronics and RCA Victor. Sunbeam. Best electric appliances made and Sunbeam Shave Master. RCA Whirlpool. Dependable home appliances to save you work and serve you well.
Fine. And now, fellas, lower your flaps, fasten your seatbelts. Here's what you've been waiting for, a special delivery for all you air males. And are you ready, fellas? Here she is from Hollywood, the very beautiful, exciting Zsa Zsa Gabor. Let's bring her on.
Hello.
Hello. What do you want to do, melt his dog tag or something? Zsa Zsa, are you happy to be here today? Tell
me. I love to be here. I love all those pilots.
You love the pilot? The pilots, dear.
I love all those pilots.
You do. You look very lovely. I love that gown. That's the nicest. I love it. You look very pretty.
Oh, Milton, it's nothing.
I know. That's why I love it. I hope the fellows love it as much as I do.
Oh, Milton, I'm sure that all those fellows have girls.
So what? Lots of men have a two-car garage. Ladies and gentlemen, and your wife. Gentlemen, it's my pleasure. You just met Zsa Zsa Gabor, the hungry doll. And now, I'd like you to meet a bit of French pastry. Here she is, the very delectable dish from Paris, Mademoiselle Denise Darcel, ladies and gentlemen.
Bonjour, mes amours. Je suis ravie de vous voir. Oh, qu'ils sont formidables, tous ces beaux garçons. Je suis contente.
Oh, you're very lovely. You're glad to be here, too. You like these jet pilots, too?
Moi, j'aime beaucoup les pilotes américains.
I don't know what she's saying. But I want to, you know, I was just complimenting Denise. You know, it's remarkable. Here's two girls from different countries, and they both had the same coastline. I'm not kidding. I was just complimenting Zsa Zsa on her gown. These girls spent a lot of money. I love this gown. That's a nice gown, too. I really...
Thank you, Mr.
Yeah?
I got it on the other side.
So that's where it is. Boy, I want to tell you, these girls, you really have beautiful... It brings out these million-dollar figures.
Milton, you really think we have million-dollar figures?
Yes. And deposited in the right places, too. Really, really.
Oh, Milton, please.
What's the matter?
Every time Zsa Zsa and I go on a show, they always talk about our figures and our faces.
She's right, Milton. I'm sure they would much rather want to admire us for our brains.
For your breath, yeah. I can see a pilot watching the both of you walking down the street and they're saying, dig those girls with the beautiful brains. It just wouldn't work, I'm telling
you. Oh, Milton.
Yeah.
These flyers, they always talk like that.
Yeah.
That's right. When I go out with a musician, I only speak about music.
Yeah.
And when I go out with a doctor, I only talk about medicine.
Well, aren't there things you can talk about when you go out with a flyer?
Oh, Milton. When you go out with a flyer,
yeah.
Who talks?
That's true.
Well, I know exactly how she feels, Milton.
Why?
Only this morning,
yeah.
I spent an hour in a plane with a flyer.
Spent an hour in a plane with a flyer? Mm-hmm. Did you have a very good flight? Huh?
What flight?
Yeah.
We never left the hangar.
In other words, you girls don't want to have dates with any of these guys at Nellis, huh?
It's like we said when we first came here. We just want to be a mother to all these men.
Oh, no.
Yes, we just want to mother them.
Oh, well, now I know it. Now I know why the supply sergeant just ordered 2,500 diapers. I'm not kidding. It looked like the return of Didi Murphy or something. But getting back to love and romance, Zsa Zsa, how about talking about love and romance?
Huh? Oh, Milton, there are much more cultural things this man would like us to talk about.
Cultural? Such as what?
Like Plato, Socrates, and Aristotle.
Plato, Socrates, and Aristotle? What are they, friends of Rubarosa? I don't know what she's talking about. What's she talking about? What is she?
Oh, Milton.
Oh.
Everybody has heard of Socrates.
Who is that?
He's the one who drank hemlock and it killed him.
Oh, well, that'll teach him to stay out of BXs. Look, girls, these fellas are not interested in philosophy. They are interested only in you girls.
We are also interested in them, but we know nothing about them.
That's right. We know nothing about them at all.
I love the way she talks. Well, what would you like to know, little child? Tell me.
Daddy Dee, tell us, please, do these pilots fly high?
Not as high as they fly when a dame passes by.
Why do fly sergeants have all those stripes on their sleeves?
Well, that's to count all the girls that they kissed while on leave.
Why do they always say I'm an F-401?
You're a jet. And to them, flying jets can be fun.
With Darcel and Gabor, they've been thrown for a loss.
Don't be sure, mes amours, cause nothing can stop the U.S. Air Force. Right? Yes, sir.
Space, Nevada, home of the Super Sabre Jet, the F-100. the fastest and most effective operational one-man fighting plane ever devised. Here, thousands of pilots are trained annually in the latest combat techniques, and a special branch of research and development performs countless experiments designed toward improving the Super Sabre Jet. With the race for speed going on all over the world, today at Nellis, official Air Force top brass from Washington have gathered to witness a vital experiment. At precisely 0800, America's most daring test pilot will attempt to establish a new speed record for jet planes.
Colonel, it's 2 minutes before takeoff. Now, what's keeping the pilot?
He should be here any minute, sir.
Well, he'd better hurry. We can't keep those congressmen waiting.
I know, sir. Well, here comes Lieutenant Berle now. Lieutenant Berle reporting, sir.
Lieutenant?
Yes.
You know the general.
Yes, sir.
Lieutenant?
Yes, sir.
You'll be going up soon. Have you been briefed?
No, I'm still wearing my long ones.
Lieutenant.
I hear it's very cold. Yes, sir.
What you're about to do must be kept very top secret.
Yes.
You understand that?
Yes,
top
sir.
Secret.
Top secret, sir. Top secret, sir.
Now,
yes.
These are your instructions.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
You'll take off at 0800.
Yes.
You'll cruise at a speed of 600 miles an hour.
Yes, sir.
And you'll break through the sound barrier until you reach a speed of 1,500 miles an hour.
Yes, sir.
Then you'll go up to 60,000 feet into the ionosphere.
Yes, sir.
And you'll start into a 9G dive and pull out at 500 feet.
Yes, sir.
Understand?
I understand.
And repeat it.
I can't.
Why not?
It's top secret. That's what you said. You said it was a top secret.
Well, you can tell it to me.
I will not. If I tell it to you, you tell it to someone else, and before you know it, the whole camp will know. You're the biggest gossip in the whole camp. He's the biggest gossip in the
Lieutenant,
whole...
Lieutenant, you realize you're talking to the colonel?
Oh, I'm sorry, General. I am confused. I thought I was talking to you.
Lieutenant, how dare you?
I'm sorry, sir.
If it weren't for the importance of this test,
yeah.
I'd have you court-martialed for talking back to your superiors.
I'm sorry, sir.
Now you have 1 minute to take off.
What is it, sir?
I said you have 1 minute to take off.
A pretty girl is like a...
No, no, not that. Get in the plane.
Yes, sir, I'll get in the plane, sir. Yes, sir.
Lieutenant?
Yes, sir.
This is a very dangerous mission.
Yes, sir.
And we expect you to succeed.
I will, sir.
Good luck.
Good luck, sir.
Good luck.
Good luck, sir.
Good luck.
Let up.
Good luck, Judy. Come on, get in the plane.
Yes, sir.
Colonel.
Yes, sir.
My biggest mission of all times.
Well, here I go.
There is a leak in the fuel tank.
Who fixed this? Who's the mechanic? Mechanic! Mechanic! Bring
yeah,
the...
Yeah, big man.
Where's
yeah,
the... You're the mechanic, Francis.
Let me understand. Don't tell me that you're the mechanic.
No, you're the mechanic. Hmm. Oh, dig this outfit.
Yeah.
You look like a disgrace from outer space.
I can't stand here arguing with you. Now, look at this. The fuel tank is leaking. Now, do something.
All right.
Fix it
immediately. Don't be so excited.
Fix it.
I'll fix it.
All right.
Your man. There.
Wait a minute. You plugged the fuel tank with spearmint?
What, then, Tutti Frutti?
I was... You're in Las Vegas. You use blackjack. Now, I want to tell you one more thing. Why don't you sit down on a cactus and get points on both ends?
Points on both things.
Now, don't...
Ooh, such satirical wit.
Don't
You're
stop.
A regular GBS.
George Bernard Shaw.
Great big slob.
I was... Now, look, if you worked on this plane, if you're the mechanic, you and I have to have a man-to-man talk.
Okay, I'm here. Who are you going to get?
I was... Do you expect me to fly in a plane where the fuel tank is plugged with chewing gum?
It's good enough to hold the wings on. It's good enough to plug the fuel on.
Now, look, will you do me a favor? One more thing. I don't think... I'm not going to... You know what would happen? You know, I would get up in the plane, 60,000 feet in the air, and I couldn't bail out before I crashed. Then what would happen?
What could happen? They'll put me in a guardhouse.
I was... Will you do me a favor? Will you stick your hand in... don't go away. Would you, stick your...
Ask me anything.
I will. Shut up. Will you stick your head in the engine and inhale while the exhaust is on? Will you do that?
The exhaust... In the exhaust! Yeah. Funny!
All right, take it easy.
Funny!
All right.
Such a brain. How come you're so clever?
Well, I don't know. I'm clever. Some guys have got it and some guys haven't got it. Just so happens I got it.
You got it, all right. Now, if somebody could just find a cure for it.
All right, enough. Now, I got to make this flight in 30 seconds. Did you check the engine?
I checked everything, including the horn.
I'm... A horn? Who needs a horn on an airplane?
Well, you gotta get them pigeons out of the way.
Now, will you, one more thing. This is ridiculous. Were you born or did your father win you at the Golden Nugget on a slot machine?
Golden Nugget? Oh, you're such a witch.
Oh, yeah. You like it. It's funny, huh?
It's nothing.
Now, listen. Don't say nothing to Burl. There's one thing I know. I know comedy. I know the secret of making people laugh.
You sure know how to keep a secret.
Oh, yeah? Well, the name of Milton Berle in the entertainment world is magic.
It sure is.
You're right, it's magic.
Oh, magic. I thought you said tragic.
Now, shut up! Can't stand here any longer. Now, did you check the turbine?
I took it apart and put it back together again piece by piece.
That's good.
And it fit perfectly.
Good, good.
Except for one thing.
What's that?
I got a piece left over.
Piece left over? Where does it belong? Don't tell me. I'll get up there and I'll find out where it belongs. One more thing. Fine, you got sixes. A fine mechanic.
The hard way.
Oh, shut up! I'll tell him. Now, fine mechanic you are. Look at my tail assembly. It's wobbly.
Well, all these GI pants fit like
oh,
that.
Oh, shut up. You don't even know what you're talking in the first place. You don't even know the first thing about planes.
I don't know.
No, you don't.
I know everything about planes, and I know everything about flying. Ask me any question.
I'll ask you one simple question.
All right.
Who were the brothers that invented the airplane?
The Ritz brothers.
Wrong.
The Smith brothers?
Wrong.
How do you like that? I can't get the Wright brothers.
That's it.
The It brothers?
Not the It brothers. See, you're wrong again. You're wrong.
All right, so I'm wrong, so I'm a loser. Give me the Cadillac and let me get out of here.
Oh, funny. Funny, 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 funny. You made it funny, just like your mother and father. Now, listen. I still think that your father won you in a slot machine at the Golden Nugget. You understand?
Now, listen, don't...
Now, listen, I got to get started. I can't stand here. The wind is blowing. The sand is... I'll perspire. You know what? I'll perspire and I'll get... Do you want me to catch a cold? Do you want me to get a virus? Do you want me to get pneumonia? Answer me.
What comes after pneumonia?
Now listen, if I get up there in the air, what's going to happen to me? You want me to tell
Lieutenant,
you what?
I know.
Lieutenant.
Yes, sir.
You should have been there 30 seconds ago. Why the delay?
Well, sir, I'm sorry, sir. It's not my fault. He fouled me up.
I fouled
yes,
you up.
Yes, you did.
I fouled him
yes.
up. Look who's talking. He's some pilot. He gets a nosebleed when he wears thick socks.
Now shut up. I'll have you know that here at this base, I am a hero. They handle me with kid gloves.
Sure, they wouldn't dare touch you with bare hands.
Oh, yeah? Well, at this place, I am the biggest ace.
Remember, you said it. I didn't say it.
I'm sorry, General. I'm off.
I don't care whose fault it is. Remember, we're running an Air Force base here, not a bus station. Do you realize that Washington is waiting for specifications on this job?
Sorry.
Why, you two men stand around here and shoot the breeze? Now, look, you. I want that plane in the air in 10 seconds. Do you hear me? Or heads will roll. Snap to it! Snap to it!
Oh, chip, 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 chip! Big man, he's giving orders. Right away, give
I'm
an
sorry,
order.
General. I have to apologize for him. I'm very, very sorry.
Poor Stark, General. What's the matter with you?
I apologize. This is the first grease monkey that ever descended from a real monkey. I think he comes from a family of illiterate baboons.
You gonna stand here and let him talk to me like that, Papa?
Papa... General, this is your son?
Yes. There are no slot machines.
How about that? Everybody gets a jackpot, he got a jackass. Sorry.
Excuse me, please.
Yes, General. Now I'm the boss around, and now get to work. Come on, get to work.
You're pushing. Don't push.
Come on, get to work.
You're such a pushy. Everybody pushes me around just because I'm a mechanic. Right. I like to be a flyer, too. I like to be glamorous and fly planes and be attractive to women. I want to live. I want to love. I want to get married.
You want to get married? Only a silly, silly, stupid jerk would have you.
Is that a proposal?
I was...
Oh, let me alone and let me get in the plane. I got to get in the plane.
Don't breathe a word. They may run out. Big trading deal. You won't tell. RCA Victor. RCA Victor.
Yes?
Spring trade-in special.
Mm-hmm.
Would you take my old TV?
Any set. Any make or model. Big allowance when you trade for one of the brand new RCA Victor Spring Specials.
RCA Victor table model. Very nice. How much?
Nationally advertised price, $199.95. With your trade-in, you get this big screen RCA Victor for less than many small screen sets.
How about this one?
Big trade-in allowance on this handsome table model, or even this television deluxe console.
Can I tell my friends about the spring specials?
Tell them all, but tell them to hurry. This offer is for a limited time only at RCA Victor dealers everywhere.
Oh, another money-saving offer, this time for music lovers. A convenient way to get RCA Victor record albums.
Your attention, please. Announcing the sensational new RCA Victor Save-On Records coupon book. Buy it for only $3.98. Get three $3.98 RCA Victor albums free. Save $24 on future purchases.
Save $24?
Three albums? Free?
Gee!
When you buy the coupon book, you get any $3.98 RCA Victor album in your dealer's store free. And two more free RCA Victor albums. One in July and one in October. But that's not all. With your RCA Victor Save On Records coupon book, you can buy $3.98 classical and popular albums for only $2.98. You can save $2 a month, $24 in a year, and you purchase only the albums you want in your choice of long play or 45 extended play featuring the world's greatest artists. But you must act now. This offer closes April 1st. The Save On Records coupon book is sold only at your RCA Victor dealers. Ask for it tomorrow.
And now, fellas, in keeping line with our policy on this show, we'd like to bring you a name act. They've been called more names than a second lieutenant. I'm only kidding. They're really great. Here they are, the seven sensational Ashtons. Come on, let's bring them on.
Thank you.
Let's hear it. 7-8. Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you very much. Come on, let's keep it. Ow, ow. Thank you. And now, I would like, gentlemen, to have you meet one of the jet pilots who's stationed here, at the base. He's seated right down there in the front row. I'd like him to stand up. Maybe we can get him up on the stage. Gentlemen, Lieutenant Dusty Schauen. Let's bring him up. Come on, guys. Turn around. Come on up here. Come on up here. Lieutenant. You're a good-looking guy, isn't he, huh? Dusty, it's a real pleasure to have you on the show tonight. May I ask you, where do you hail from?
From Texas, sir.
Texas? Sir, I'm out of the other outfit already. You're from Texas? What part of Texas?
From Brownsville.
When they move it from Brooklyn. Oh, Brownsville, Texas. Exactly, I think our audience would be interested. Where is Brownsville, Texas?
It's about 250 miles south of San Antonio.
I see. And your town must be very proud of what you're doing.
Yes, sir, they were until just a few minutes ago.
Who writes your material? Colonel McGee or something? No, you come from Brownsville, Texas? I played there in vaudeville years ago. And the whole town turned out.
Really?
Yeah.
Did you get away?
Yeah. Out of 5,000 guys, I had to pick this guy? May I ask you, what do you do here at the base here?
I'm an instructor pilot with the 3594th Combat Crew Training Squadron. It's the F-100 fighter conversion course at Nellis.
It's like Gone with the Wind, that whole thing. I mean, how long have you been a pilot?
About 5 years.
5 years, I see. And I see by the ribbons you've had campaigns. And what campaigns were you in?
I was in Korea in 1952.
I see. And how many missions? I think you've got to know how many missions you flew.
About 37.
37. Must have been real rugged. And I guess you were under tremendous physical pressure during all these missions. Is that right? Well, that brings us to what I'm about to do now. That's the reason I asked you to come up here. You see, the reason I asked you, up to now, it's been practically impossible, and I want to tell these gentlemen down, it's practically impossible to judge a pilot's mental reaction when he's under stress and strain. Well, Lieutenant, I'm proud to announce that here at Nellis, after months of painstaking experiments, the Air Force has finally developed a machine capable of reading the secret inner thoughts of a pilot when pressure is applied to him. And with your permission, we'd like to have you be the first man who has ever tested it. It's a mechanical, powerful thing called the M604, and the Air Force's new amazing thought machine. Would you care to be our guinea pig? Go ahead. No, come on, it's painless. Would you like it? Would you do it?
All right, sir.
All right, fine. All right, will you bring it in, please? Bring in the thought machine. Bring it right down. Thank you very much. Now, are you sure you want to volunteer? Now, I'd like this clearly understood that you're doing this of your own volition.
Yes,
is that right, Lieutenant Schauen?
That's right.
Schauen, is it? S-H-O-W-N. Is that right? All right. Now, I want to tell you. Now, here's the way, if you do good with this, you might be transferred to United Airlines. Now, here's the way it works. You see, may I take your hat off? I fit a plane. I hope it's one of ours. And it surely is, too. Here is the helmet that goes over your head. Now, you stand here, and it's got to fit very snug and partly. Let me turn it this way. It's got to fit very snugly and very, very tightly. Now, is that all right? It's not too tight, is it? Now, here's what we're ready. We're going to apply various degrees of pressure on you, and we'll see how much you can take. You feel pretty strong today?
Yes, sir, I suppose so.
Got you in the spot. No more jokes now, huh? Now, good. Now, may I step over here? Would you pardon me, sir? Now, this wire leads right into this great mechanical machine. And when you have this skull cap on your head, we show the pressure of your inner thoughts. Now, when the pressure is applied on you, through this tape is printed your inner thoughts, and I'll read it. You know what I mean? The secret of your inner thoughts. You get that? Now, remember this? Be careful. We're on television. Now, all right, we're going to use the pressure machine. Would you bring out the pressure apparatus, please? Bring it out, please. Bring it all the way down. Straight down here. Fine? All the way down there, boys. That's fine. Now, Now, here, I want to warn you, Lieutenant, that this pressure device is the most powerful ever developed. You don't have to be ashamed if you can't resist it, because it has driven stronger men than you to a breaking point. Gentlemen, open it up. Where shall we send the body? Now, there she is. There she is, Lieutenant. That's our pressure device, the Hungarian... Wait till we do... The Hungarian flamethrower. This is Zsa Zsa Gabor. Now, she's going to put pressure on you, and you've got to fight. Fight! You understand? All right, Zsa Zsa, now, just a minute. Let me tell you. Turn up your pilot light and see if you can light up the pilot. Start. Go ahead.
Darling! Did anybody ever tell you how handsome you are? Oh, those exciting eyes. Oh, those manly features. And the skin I love to touch.
Hold it. Hold it. It's coming across. Look what it says. I wonder what we're going to have for chow? Oh, this is murder. With a dish like this, he's thinking about food. Will you give him a little more pressure, please?
Darling, may I hold your strong hand?
Put it on.
Oh, they are so strong. Darling, please. Please take me in your strong, strong arms.
Hold it. Hold it. Coming up. I gotta see that movie Kim Novak is in. Oh. You're still there, kid. Go on, more pressure, more pressure.
Oh, you have such soft lips.
It's coming now. It's working now. Hurry up.
Please press your lips against mine.
I got it. Boy, could I go for a cold beer. What is it? Oh, this is murder now. Come on, put more pressure on him. More pressure. Go ahead. That's it. Wait a minute, hold it, it's coming up. I'll settle for a bottle of Pepsi-Cola? I don't know, when he first come out here, I could have sworn he was alive. We got to put double pressure on him.
I'd like to try.
You'd like to try?
Yes.
Oh, he's an iceberg.
Oh, actually, I will break him down. Leave it to me, Milton.
Yeah, you'll defrost him, huh?
I will defrost him, all right.
All right, let's switch
it's
places.
All yours.
All right, go ahead.
Parlez-moi d'amour, redites-moi des choses tendres.
I wonder if she plays ping pong. What is it? Oh, this is murder. Go ahead.
Votre beau discours en carré à la belle entendre.
I hope my draft board gets poison pen letters. She wants to play post office and he's thinking about letters. This I don't know. Start again, honey. Go ahead. Watch this. I gotta get that vibration out of my left wing. This guy's made of stone. Now, look, will you switch over here, please? Zsa Zsa, will you give him the combined effort? Start again, honey.
Zsa vous aime.
Gee, these G.I. shoes are tight. I want to tell you, if the enemy had him... He had him for the resistance, the war would still be on. This I give up. Nothing can break this guy down.
You
may come from Brownsville, Texas, but they have make him strong down in Texas. Who's this girl?
Excuse me, Mr. Burrow, may I try?
You try? I don't know the young lady. We've tried everything else. Be my guest. Go ahead. Well, this is murder. Zsa Zsa and Denise couldn't move him. I don't get the bit. Who are you?
Come
Thank you, Lieutenant Schoen. Thank you very much. And now, here's the message from Dundee.
Hello, I'm Peg Murdoch. You know, I'm really thrilled with the way millions of women are now enjoying the Sunbeam Controlled Heat Automatic Fry Pan. You've heard about it, I'm sure, through its very best advertisement, the woman who owns one. It's the most useful appliance I ever had in my home. So useful, I keep it out all the time. All I've been getting is compliments for my food since I got my Sunbeam Fry Pan. That's why I'm so enthusiastic about it. Now, these women are typical. In fact, we've just finished talking with thousands like them. And you know, 97% are recommending the Sunbeam Fry Pan to their friends and relatives. Why? Because the Sunbeam makes everything you cook more delicious. Here's how. Sunbeam's Fry Guide, as you can see on this enlargement, shows the correct temperature for preparing your favorite food. For example, you just dial your Sunbeam for 300 degrees, and you'll have eggs that are perfect every time. And more delicious, too. Now, just think of it. No more eggs that are blistered and burned around the edges, yet raw on top. And no more bacon that's burned and curled because the pan was too hot. Why, now you just set your Sunbeam for 340 degrees, and your bacon will look better and taste better, too. And you can cook 20% more in the Sunbeam because of its square shape. And you know, it's water-sealed, so you can immerse it in water right up to the control dial for quick and easy washing. Be sure you get the genuine and original controlled heat automatic fry pan. Yes, I mean the one and only Sunbeam controlled heat automatic fry pan. And don't forget this special Sunbeam offer. You can still get a $7.50 trade-in allowance for your old mixer. That's regardless of its age, make, or condition, on the famous Sunbeam Mixmaster Blender combination. But do hurry, because it's for a limited time only. And remember, it's by Sunbeam, the best electric appliances made.
Okay, guys. You know, fellas, here at Nellis Air Force Base, you know, one of the hottest outfits in the recording field today is Ray Anthony and a sensational orchestra. And now, with the assistance of the lovely Copa girls from the very fabulous Sands Hotel in Las Vegas, here is Ray and the boys bringing you their latest hit recording. And if you think the desert is hot, just wait till you hear Madeira. Take it away, Ray.
Thank you.
Anthony, gentlemen, let's put a spotlight. Stand up, take him out. Ray, wonderful. We will be right back. Don't go away, we'll be right back after a 30-second pause for station identification. Don't go away.
Keep tuned to Milton Berle, Zsa Zsa Gabor, and Denise Darcel in color.
Fellas, if you think the F-100 is built for speed, well, you get a load of the next act. Here are four guys, well, with feet faster than your... They go faster than your paycheck at Vegas. And here they are, the dynamic four stepbrothers. Let's bring them on.
Hey! is a dramatic presentation.
Kukla, stop washing those delicate fabrics by hand.
But I must wash these flimsies by hand, for there is no washer that can wash them safely.
Oh, but there is the new two-speed RCA Whirlpool that...
Hold it, madam. Just a moment. Just a moment. Come with me, young man. And here it is now, the new dragon-size RCA Whirlpool washer with two different speeds, two adjustable time cycles, both in one automatic washer. And this wonderful feature here...
Please, Ollie.
Oh, sorry, Fran. I'm a madcap.
Wait a minute, Choo-Choo. Let's be serious. Fran, can you show me how the new two-speed RCA Whirlpool washes all fabrics and saves me work, time, and money?
Well, I certainly can with my new housewife-size RCA Whirlpool. You know, the new RCA Whirlpool gives you two speeds as well as two adjustable time cycles.
That's all.
Just set the dial for regular wash, and automatically you get the right speed for sheets, towels, blue jeans, your regular laundry.
Mm-hmm.
Another flip of the dial, and automatically you get a one-third slower speed, just right for delicate fabrics you've been afraid to wash before, except by hand. And the spin slows down a third, too.
Gee, Fran, that's wonderful.
So now you see, Kukla, you can wash anything that's washable automatically in the new RCA Whirlpool.
Golly, Fran, those two speeds handle almost any kind of laundry. It's like having two machines in one.
Well, yes. You just talk to a woman who uses an RCA Whirlpool, then see your RCA Whirlpool dealer. Ask him to show you the new two-speed RCA Whirlpool washer and matching dryer.
This has been a dramatized presentation.
Ow! Excuse me.
Thank you. Gentlemen, well, that's about it for tonight. But before we go, I would like to introduce Colonel McGee, the commanding officer of Nellis Air Force Base. Commander. Colonel. That's your man. That's your man. I know that we've done a lot of kidding about the Air Force tonight, but I'm sure that you and the gentlemen and the fellas take it all in the spirit of fun.
Well, we understand that, Milton. And I think this has been a great morale booster for the troops.
Thank you very much.
And thank you very much for bringing the show tonight.
Well, thank you, and God bless you. And let's thank Colonel McGee and send him off. Thank you very, very much. Ladies and gentlemen, next week, Bob Hope. And I'll be back 3 weeks from tonight from San Diego for the Naval Force. Good night. Good night, everyone. Thank you. Go.
Hi, you're watching Classic TV here on Wayback Machine 1, the classic shows and movies you grew up with, 100% free. I hope you'll subscribe today. Thanks.
Watch Classic TV on Wayback Machine 1. We'll take your hand on the showbiz land and we'll bring back fun to you. Come watch with me, we'll watch away. Come watch TV on Wayback Machine 1. Just stay right there and we'll keep you square and we'll bring back fun for you. Watch TV on Wayback Machine 1.